Hi everybody, we finally got our hands on the Panorama CS12 from Nektar Tech. The CS12 is a channel strip controller for Logic Pro X. And to be honest, I've been looking for a solid controller for Logic Pro for quite some time. So take along and let's try the CS12 in a real world mixing scenario. And I'll show you my favorite tricks on the CS12. But first out, a big thanks to Nektar Tech for sending me a demo unit of the CS12. Let's take the tour. First off, we have a motorized fader to the left side of the CS12. And if we step through the different tracks in our arrangement, you can see that the motorized fader reflects the volume of that track. And you can also walk through the different tracks by holding down the track selector key here and moving the data encoder. You'll see that the yellow bar moving, which is the track selector. And then just release the track selector and you will select that track. So it's a quicker way to move between the different tracks. Before we begin from scratch with this mix, let's take a quick listen to a section here so you can get a feel for what kind of track we have. So we can use the play key. And turn off the metronome. We will begin like with any other type of a mixing session. So let's go through all the tracks and make sure we have the volumes at the lowest level. Let's begin with the drum track. Something like that. Then we can step to the bass track. Maybe introduce some guitars. Then when we want to listen to the crash, we need to move to that place in the arrangement. You can see I can hold down one of these forward and backwards arrows and move the data encoder to move to a specific place a little bit faster in my arrangement. So let's just set the marker right before we have the crash hit and also deactivate the looping and press play in here. The volume for the crash. And the final track. Okay, so now we have a nice balance in the volumes between the tracks. And the next thing we're gonna do here is look at the different audio effects and how we can control the different plugins on the tracks. So now we select the guitar lead here. And as you can see, we have a little strip in the middle of the CS12. And that is for controlling the different plugins. So first we're gonna see the 8 different plugin effects. If you have more than 8 effects, you can press this top button and it will move to the audio effects 9 to 16. But we only have 4 plugins on this track. We have a compressor, channel EQ, the Galfos plugin and the Combat Kid, which is a delay plugin from Baby Audio. Now, if we want to bring up the plugin, we can just press that button and we will get to see that plugin on the computer. And we also can see all the different parameters available instantly here in that specific plugin. The comeback kid delay here is a third-party plugin, but you can see it still works with the CS12. We can get to see all the different parameters. We have the delay time. And we can change the feedback and all these other parameters of the plugin. We can also change from ping pong or mono and flip between the different pages if we want to see if there's more parameters available. So let's solo this track and fiddle a little bit with the parameters. So press solo on the channel strip control. So you can see it's a very quick control and very easy to control the different parameters really quickly from the knobs here on the CS12. And if we want to hide the plugin, you can always press that plugin button. So we can bring up the plugin and hide the plugin with that button if you want to see your arrangement instead. So let's move back to the arrangement again, a little bit earlier in the arrangement. And press play and fiddle a little bit more with the parameters. So that was the comeback kid delay. Now we can also change the equalizer if we want. Just select that second slot on our track. There we have the equalizer, and you can see instantly we have access to the different nodes. So we can change the high pass filter here or low cut filter. And do some wah-wah effect. But I'm just going to use the low cut here for some basic low cut. Next up, let's look at the compressor. Just doing some light compression. And we can quickly change the circuit type or the compressor type. Just like that. So let's go out of solo mode and make another tap on the stop button to go to the beginning of the arrangement. At the bottom of the plugin strip, you can see that we can gain access to sends and also the channel controls. But let's look at the sends here. I only have one single send effect on this guitar track, which sends to a Valhalla room reverb. Now, if we want to automate that and maybe add the send only at specific sections in the track, we can easily do that. Let's get rid of the plugin here first. And go back to the send, and we're going to activate the automation. And now we can adjust the send level here at different sections of the track. And as you can see, when we have the select button activated and we move any of the parameters, we also get that parameter control on the motorized fader. We have more granular control over the exact data value with the motorized fader. So let's press play, activate the automation with the automation button here. So we change from read to latch. And let's ride a send level for the reverb on this guitar track. Thank you. Yeah, and then now let's do the same thing with the delay on the insert effect here to control maybe the wet level. So we go back to the beginning of the arrangement. Yeah, so you can see how easy it is to add some effects variation here with the automation really quickly on the different parameters of the plugins with the CS12. Okay, so let's close the automation here and go to another track. We remember to deactivate the automation and change from latch to read with the auto button here. Right, so with the bass track, we're going to change the compressor settings. So press the first plugin slot here, which is the compressor. And then maybe we can change the compressor type from the Platinum to the Studio VCA instead, which is a little bit more powerful. And let's adjust the volume of the Rhodes here in context with the mix. Yeah, as you can see, you get very quick access to granular mixing controls in Logic Pro with the CS12. And we basically never need to touch either the mouse or the keyboard to do the different tasks we need here for the mixing stage. The only downside with the Logic Pro is that they don't provide a convenient way of adding plugins from controllers. And this is by no means a Nektar Tech fault, this is rather an Apple API issue. I talked to Nektar Tech support about this issue, and apparently they've asked Apple about this issue, and hopefully Apple can provide a better and more convenient way of adding plugins in their API at a later stage, so we can have that implemented into the CS12 too, because that's like the only thing that I'm missing here in the control communication between our controller and the DAW Logic Pro. Okay, so I hope you liked this video. Please let me know if you want to see more about the CS12, and let me know in the comments if you have any questions or feedback. Thanks for watching today, and I'll see you in the next episode. Bye.